We do and we don't. We know a lot more than we used to. We know that pancreatic cancer runs in families often because family members have a defective gene that they passed on to other family members. And we know this, for example, if we take the Angelina Jolie BRCA gene, we know that BRCA gene mutations can cause pancreatic cancer to run in families, much like it can cause breast and ovarian cancer. And there are a number of other genes like the BRCA gene that are also responsible for causing pancreatic cancer. There's a lot of effort underway to try and understand all of the genes responsible for a family developing pancreatic cancer, but there's still a lot we don't know. And we can't forget as well that the same reasons that cause the disease to run in people where it doesn't run in families, such as smoking and lifestyle and environment and exercise, these are probably also important factors in families as well. The question of genetic tests comes up a lot. We hear about it a lot in the news, and it is an important question. And we do recommend genetic testing for some people who have pancreatic cancer that runs in their families. We don't offer it to everyone. The reason is because we have to consider how likely it is we're going to find useful information that's going to help our patients. So if we find families have multiple affected individuals with pancreatic cancer, what we do is we like them to see a genetic counselor and or a physician with expertise in guiding a patient through the genetic counseling process, understanding the kind of result that they might have, because it has implications for family members. Currently, we understand some of the genetics of familial pancreatic cancer, but there's still a lot we don't know. So very often when we offer people a genetic test, we get an inconclusive or negative result. And one of the important messages there is that, well, that doesn't mean that we can conclude one way or the other whether or not their pancreatic cancer that they have or that some of their relatives has can be definitively explained. But we do think it is very helpful for selected families to undergo genetic testing. And this can not only provide help for the families, but even the affected individual with pancreatic cancer, because sometimes that has important treatment implications, and that can be discussed with their doctor. So the current best test for screening for pancreatic cancer is a test involving imaging the pancreas. So looking for tumors directly by imaging. And there have been some excellent studies comparing the different types of tests that are involved. We can do endoscopic ultrasound, which is like having an endoscope with an ultrasound all in one. A patient undergoes sedation, and we have a very careful review of the pancreas, and we believe in general that that's the most accurate test. There are other tests that can be very useful. For example, an MRI scan allows us to visualize the pancreas very well as well, particularly pancreatic cysts. And so in the screening setting, those are the two main tests we offer our patients who are undergoing screening. If we suspect that there may be more going on in their pancreas, if there's something abnormal we want to look at further, we'll ask the patient to undergo a CT scan. We like to avoid CT scanning on a regular basis because of the radiation dose, which although is very low, we'd prefer to avoid. Currently, there isn't an effective blood test to diagnose pancreatic cancer, particularly to diagnose pancreatic cancer at an early stage when it's curable, which is what we really want from a screening test. There's a lot of research that's interesting, and we're hopeful that we'll be able to develop a pancreatic cancer test that's just a blood test that could be used for screening. When we look at our pancreatic screening studies, most patients who undergo pancreatic screening, thankfully, will have a completely normal pancreas. A significant fraction of patients will have small pancreatic cysts. Thankfully, most of those will never develop into pancreatic cancer and can be followed. A very small number of patients will have a small pancreatic mass that, in fact, is a pancreatic cancer. And in many cases, that's a curable, treatable pancreatic cancer. It is worth trying to detect pancreatic cancer early. There are patients who are cured of their pancreatic cancer if it's detected early. We have had patients with pancreatic cancer detected through screening who've lived for many years and we believe are cured from their pancreatic cancer. And the key point is detecting it early. And that means detecting small pancreatic cancers while they're still confined to the pancreas. It's also true that gradually pancreatic cancer treatment is improving. And so we believe that patients should undergo a screening if they meet pancreatic screening criteria. Besides undergoing pancreatic screening, people who are concerned about their risk of developing pancreatic cancer, we advise them to have a healthy lifestyle, to not smoke, to avoid excess alcohol, to exercise well, and have a good diet. And we make these recommendations based on evidence that patients who develop pancreatic cancer are more likely to be obese, to smoke, although we don't have evidence that these lifestyle remedies will actually prevent you from developing pancreatic cancer. We also know that these are very good general health recommendations, and that's why we recommend them for patients.